Good evening and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Glad to have our visitors with us this evening. A lot of familiar faces we've seen in the past and family, and just glad to have you all here. For those of you who haven't, don't know about the offering plate, we're not going to collect an offering in the hallway. There's a plate in the back, on the back of the sanctuary for offering if you wish to put anything in there. We also invite you back tomorrow morning. There will be no communion this evening, but we will have communion tomorrow morning at our service, so you're welcome to come back tomorrow morning. Also, during the lighting of the candles, when we sing Silent Night, Mike asked, are we going to play through one time? Okay, Mike's going to play through this Silent Night one time before we sing, then we'll begin to sing. Does anyone have anything else for the good of the congregation this evening? Now let us gather in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and as we praise the Lord and worship our newborn Jesus Christ, we let us prepare our hearts and minds as we listen to the prayer.
Every living stone. Well, I'm looking on here. I don't see anything about what I'm supposed to do. So I was confused. Welcome. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
That's what we're going to do tonight. We're going to celebrate Christ's birth. Some of you, throughout the year, you don't think about such things, and that's understandable in part. But in reality, we should be thinking about his birth, his life, his death, his burial, his resurrection year-round. Amen?
Amen.
We need to think of Christ. And that's what we're going to do tonight. We're going to exalt him and lift him up, praise him. So I hope you join me. I hope you join the people next to you and praise God in your singing, in your attention. When you leave here, praise God. We have a lot to be thankful for. Amen. Let's pray. Almighty God, I asked that you would bless the proceedings tonight, bless this service. We're having it for your Son, Jesus Christ. We want to lift him up because he's going to lift us up. In Jesus' name. Amen.
May the same thrill and anticipation that filled Mary
the chosen mother of Jesus, consume us and draw us close to you. May our spirits cry out, Alleluia, with the host of angels who first delivered the good news of great joy to humble, awestruck shepherds that night so long ago. The news that would literally one day be heard around the world. Help us remember and reflect on the awesome prophecies foretelling your birth since the beginning of time. Give us eyes of faith to see on this side of the cross what prophets chose to believe through promises and visions. Emmanuel, God with us, Prince of Peace, the Son of God, Messiah. May all that you are saturate our senses and fill our hearts with both gratitude and worship as we bow this evening before you and offer our prayer to you. Just as the three Magi brought their offerings in celebration of your birth, we bring you gifts too, the declaration of our obedience and devotion to you, the quieting of our hearts and spirits, and a joyful overflow of worship and adoration. May this preparation night be a holy night as we once again receive and celebrate your great gift to us this Christmas. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Footstool for your feet.
The Lord will extend your mighty scepter from Zion,
and you will rule in the midst of your enemies.
Your troops will be willing on your day of battle. Arrayed in holy majesty, from the womb of the dawn, you will receive the dew of your mouth.
The Lord has sworn with my hand in his mind. You are a priest forever, in the order of the most
high. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made complete in us. We know that we live in him and he in us, because he has given us of his Spirit. And we have seen and testified that the Father has sent his Son to be the Savior of the world. If anyone acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God lives in him and he in God. And so we know and rely on the love God has for us. God is love. Whoever lives in love lives in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
From the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 1, verses 18 through 25.
Glory to you, O Lord.
This is how the birth of Jesus came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man, and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived of her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said to the prophet. The virgin will be with child, and they will call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she gave birth to her son, and he gave him the name Jesus, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Well, I'm glad you could all come out this evening. It's a cold evening. I was telling somebody on the way in, I felt like something covering Jesus up out in that nativity scene. It's awful cold. We appreciate you being here. Hopefully your hearts will be warm as you sit and sing songs of praise and listen to God's word. It always warms your heart if your heart is attentive to God. You know that? Eventually your heart will be warmed and you'll feel better. I'm not going to speak on any particular passage. I'm going to speak of several passages just briefly. I may have seen Home Alone. The Grinch that stole Christmas. It's a Wonderful Life. The Christmas Story. All these different movies. The top 10. Not one of them mentioned or have much to do or anything to do with Jesus Christ. I like them too. But that's where we're at in society today. So we're going to talk tonight about remembering Jesus. Remembering and never forgetting Jesus. And saying that name as often as we can. Jesus. Jesus. Jehovah saves. 2,000 years ago, Jerusalem was filled with pyrotechnics. The sky was lit up. Now, I don't know exactly how it worked. The glory of the Lord shone round about them. You know that passage. But the glory of the Lord was very bright and brilliant, according to Old Testament passages. It led the children of Israel out of Egypt through night, guarding them through the day. It was a very bright light. And you know as well as I that 2,000 years ago, the ones who came to see him that night, because they had to stay in a stable, in a manger, because there was what? No room for them in the inn. And who came to visit them? The shepherds. The shepherds. And as soon as they heard of the birth of Jesus from the angels who heralded it brilliantly to the shepherds, what did they do? They responded. You know, the Christmas message, just like the gospel message, is a message you hear and you can't help but share it with someone else. So they came, as the angel told them, and they see Mary and the babe, and then they left immediately and went out and shared that message. It provoked a response. You know, I challenge you. Share the Christmas story either in full or in part with someone. It'll bless your heart. Start off sharing the Christmas story with someone. And then build up and share the crucifixion, the resurrection. Because if you're really a child of God, you will share his gospel. You know that? Well, that happened on a certain night 2,000 years ago. And then 6 to 9 months, could be possibly a year later, wise men came. And they claimed they were anywhere from 700 to 1,200 miles to the east. And they traveled west to Jerusalem. It says in Matthew 2:2, when they ran into Herod, who wanted Jesus dead, it's very clear. They said to Herod, "We saw his star." And it's very specific. It was his star. A lot of times at Christmas time, we give other people glory. And please, I'm all for giving gifts, receiving, all that. But not at the sake of Jesus Christ. They saw his star, they said, and we have come to worship. not just share the gospel like the shepherds did, they've come to worship Jesus. Herod said, well, where is he to be born? And they said, in Bethlehem. He said, go find a child and tell me when you found him. He was up to no good. And then they went and found the child. The star led them to where Jesus was. And they did exactly what they said. They fell down and worshiped. And they gave him gold and frankincense and myrrh. Wise men, we don't know if they were magi, kings, a combination of both, but it was more than three. They traveled in large groups, and they came to see Jesus. Think about that. In Jerusalem, the only ones that really came to see him were the shepherds. There were thousands and hundreds of thousands of people in the area, and only the shepherds knew the prophecy, or came to see him because they heard the angel. And 9 months later, a year later, the wise men came because people forgot. We don't want to forget Jesus. It said it's his star. I want you to make sure you understand this. It's his story tonight. We can make it about anything we want, but we celebrate because it's his story, and we've used that as a play on words. History. His story. It says in Colossians 1:14, in whom we have redemption through his blood. Nobody else's blood was shed on Calvary's cross but his. It was his blood. Even the forgiveness of sins. What did the angel said? He should be called Jesus because he shall save his people from their sins. Colossians 1:20, and having made peace through the blood of his cross. So it was his blood, his cross, his star. Scripture is very specific. This isn't about any one individual. This is about Jesus Christ. Let's not forget it. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, by himself, to reconcile all things to himself, I say whether in things in earth or things in heaven. He wanted to bring his people. Hebrews 1 says, the captain of our salvation tasted death so he could bring many sons unto glory. And it says in 1:22, in the body of his flesh through death, to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. Think about that. His star, his blood, his cross, his flesh, his story. Hebrews 5:9 says, he is the author of eternal salvation. He wrote it. To all those who obey him. He wrote this story. And he didn't just write it on a piece of paper. He wrote it in real life. He lived it out. Think about it. Let's not forget Jesus. We have a tendency to want to forget, especially over time. There's a story in Luke, and you're going to think, why is he using this as a Christmas story? It's in Luke 2, in verses 41 through 51. And I want to read it to you, or part of it. Jesus was left alone. Not home alone, but he was left alone. He's the gift of God. Would you leave the gift of God lay? Would you leave it and not pick it up? Would you leave the gift of God, who's a person, and forget? Mary did. Joseph did. It says in verse 41, now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at a feast of the Passover. This is Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up to Jerusalem after the custom of the feast. So you know what they're doing? They're busy in their activities. You know, you can actually go to church, do things like this, come here, and not be really focused on Jesus, and you're not pleasing God at all. And they were busy about Passover. See, Mary must have forgotten, or part of her had forgotten 12 years earlier, her song of praise to God.
sort of like a 9/11. Remember when they were singing in front of the Capitol steps, God bless America, within the first week? In this country today, that would never happen. We forget so quickly. And when they had fulfilled the days, they returned the child Jesus tarried behind in Jerusalem, and Joseph, his mother, didn't know it. She was unaware. See, it sneaks up on you. Life's activities. It sneaks up on you. You get busy, right? And you become unaware. They, supposing him to have been in the company, went a day's journey, and they sought him among their kinsfolks and acquaintance. They went a day's journey out of Jerusalem, and they were looking for him amongst their family, and they couldn't find him. When they found him not, they turned back again to Jerusalem. Then there's a panic sets in. But the gift of God, we left him behind. And I'm sure they weren't thinking that. It was my son. I left him behind. But in actuality, they left the gift of God back in Jerusalem. And it came to pass after 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst with doctors, both hearing and asking them questions. And all that heard him were astonished. Now it's a surprise. At his understanding and his answers. When they saw him, they were amazed. And his mother said unto him, Son, why hast thou dealt with us this way? Behold thy father, and I have sought you sorrowing. Mary had forgotten, and Joseph had forgotten what happened 12 years prior. He said unto them, How is it that you sought me? Wist you not that I was about my father's business? I'm doing what I was called to do. And you shouldn't have forgotten. Now, Mary was a wonderful mother. But you see how we forget activities and things get caught up in our mind. And then we assume, well, it's okay. Just like Mary assumed Jesus was with him. And then eventually they figured out, wait a minute, he's not here. And then the panic sets in. Now, this is a story that happened 2,000 years ago. And it's not like we forget today with our activities, but the principle is still the same. The activities of life take us away from the truth of God's word and Jesus. And then we think everything's okay. And then we start to sense he's not with us. So we panic and we start seeking his presence. And you know, he's doing what his father asked him to do. And here's the thing, he asks us to do the same. In reality, they should have been where Jesus was. Romans 6:23 says, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Don't forget that. Don't forget Jesus. From the cradle to the cross, don't forget Jesus. I have some words written down here. He came from heaven to earth so we could go to heaven. Rags to riches, 2 Corinthians 8 says, he was made poor even though he was rich so we might be made rich. The immortal became mortal so we could become immortal. God become man so we could become the sons of God. The infinite became an infant for each and every one of you. Just like he took that nail for each and every one of you, he came as a child for each and every one of us. Jesus. Jesus. Ephesians 2:8. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that faith, not of yourselves, it is a gift of God. Let's not forget the gift of God. The psalmist says this in Psalm 50:22. Now consider this, you that forget God, lest I tear you in pieces, and no one can save you.
Don't forget it. Whosoever offers praise like the wise men did and the shepherds, glorifies me, and to him that ordereth his behavior aright, will I show the salvation of God. Also repeats the same in Psalm 9:17. All the nations that forget God will be destroyed. Then it says, remember, in Revelation 2:4-5, remember your first love. Remember from where you're fallen and repent and come back to Jesus Christ. If you've never met him, meet him tonight. Not just in words, in heart. Receive him tonight. Remember the thief on the cross? What did he say? Lord, remember me when you enter into your kingdom. What did Jesus say? Today, you will be with me in heaven. There's nothing wrong with these movies we watch. I like them. I like many of them. But Satan's up to no good. And if we're watching the top 10 favorite of all time are non-Christian Christmas movies, eventually they're going to do away with Christmas. Let's not forget Jesus. He came as a babe. And all along, 33 years later, he was going to die on Calvary's cross and give his blood, his cross, his blood, his body, his flesh. John the Baptist says, he must increase, I must decrease. Let's keep him in the forefront of our mind this Christmas season and after. Amen?
Amen.
Let's pray. Almighty God, I thank you for your word. I thank you for Jesus. Thank you for such a great salvation. Thank you for the unspeakable gift you give us. Lord, thank you for coming into this world and dying for this sinner right here. For everyone else too, but I'm just thinking you died for me. And I thank you. And I praise you. Thank you for taking on human form. What an awesome, awesome task. We ask that we would bless you the remainder of the evening. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Father of light, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified on the cross of Calvary. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and Son. With the Father and Son, we worship and glorify. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge our baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come.
Please pray with me. Most merciful
God, I confess I am
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. And as a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, Jesus' authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Thank you.
this evening, I challenge you. Share the Christmas story. Share Christ with someone who you think needs it. Share the gift. Don't forget the gift tonight or this season. How many more chances are we going to have in this life to share the gift of God? May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. God bless.
May God, who sent his angel to